Welcome back to another show, everybody. This is You Made Roscoe. I am Roscoe. I'm here with my partner in crime, Silk Threads, from Silk and the Guys podcast and variety show. In today's show, we're going to be doing a reaction to the song Rap Devil by Machine Gun Kelly. And to be honest, Machine Gun Kelly is somebody who I haven't really paid any attention to, really. So I can't name one song that I know of his or nothing like that. So this is kind of like really my introduction to him, even though I know he's existed for like all this time. You know what I mean? Been in the game forever. But what about you, Silk? You familiar with songs by this dude?
I mean, if somebody had a gun in my head, be like, sing a Machine Gun Kelly song, or you dead.
You dead, G. It's over.
Not at all.
It's over. Yeah, no, it's probably over for me too. But we finna get introduced to him now. So probably the person catch us after this.
Right.
You know, and we'll be able to say, like, no, dude. I heard before we continue, I'd like to ask that everybody please subscribe if you haven't already. And make sure you hit the notification bell. That's just so that you'll be notified when future shows arise and all that stuff. So there's that, you know. So me and Silk, we're going to go ahead and get into this Rap Devil thing. See what MGK got to talk about. What he talking about.
What it talking about then?
What it do. All right.
Hey, somebody grab some clippers. This fucking beard is weird. Tough talk from a rapper paying millions for security a year. I think my dad's gone crazy. Yeah, Haley, you right. Dad's always mad, cooped up in the studio, yelling at the mic. You sober and bored, huh? I know. I'm about to be 46 years old, dog. Talking about, I'ma call up Trick Trick. You sound like a bitch, bitch. Man, I can handle your shit. Mad about something I said in 2020.
Man, this dude, he wilding out so far. Rolling out so far, you know, they have to go in on the man's beard, or you know, the ageism. You know, I hate that happens. And it's
it only happens in rap.
Only happens in hip hop, dude. You know what I mean? Like nobody else in no other genre is shaming somebody for having staying power.
expiration dates, man. They treat rappers like milk.
Yeah, it's horrible. Yeah.
I want to see a 75-year-old rapper up there still trying to give it his all. We watch, they go on a cruise every year with Earth, Wind, and Fire.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
No, but we probably be that first generation to where, like, you know, we be on the cruises and, you know, KRS is like 180 and still. Everybody came, you know what I mean? You know, some other guys, but yeah, no, that we probably be that generation, you know, but that's the only thing that I'll be tripping off of. But otherwise, you know, it seemed like the Machine Gun is going in, you know, he's getting off on Eminem. And that's another thing that I forgot to mention, that this is a Eminem diss, apparently. You know,
yeah, I figured that out when he said Haley. He was talking about that man and threw his daughter in there. He must really wanted to fight. Is this a retaliation song or is this the first strike?
No, I'm not exactly sure because
put it in the comments. Put it in the comments. Yeah, we want to know that. Is this a retaliation song or is this a clap back? Because if it's a retaliation song.
I'm not sure how this went, who started and all that other stuff. So again, I wasn't somebody who cared about, you know, what was going on with this guy too much, and And I ain't want to put it like that, but you know, that's just where I was at. You know, I like, but a lot of guys, and it'd be a lot of rappers like that who I don't pay no attention to at one point, but then I end up catching back to them. That's the one good thing about this age that we live in. It's like, you know, it's given me the opportunity to catch back up on some guys in some era, in an era that I kind of miss completely just because I wasn't paying attention.
We probably was running the streets around this era.
Yeah. I mean, no, this would have to be, I feel like this got to be like the 2010s or something, you know, still.
I'm talking about, man.
At the time, you know, but you can go ahead.
Gotcha.
Well, took you 6 years and a surprise out just to come with a diss. Mommy, we get it. We know that you're the greatest rapper alive. Fucking dweeb, all you do is read the dictionary and stay inside. Fuck rap god, I'm the rap devil. I'm a bare face with a black shovel like the Armageddon. When the smoke settle, his body next to this instrumental, I'm saying. Sick of them sweatsuits and them corny hats, let's talk about it. Sick of you being rich and you still mad, let's talk about it. All of us sing bass from the Midwest, we can talk about it. Or we can get gully, I'll size up your body and put some white chalk around it. Let's talk about the fact.
It's funny with these guys too, because I think about like a lot of white rappers that came after Eminem. You know what I mean? And think about the fact that they and this is something that we wouldn't think about, but they came up in a world where if they wanted to be a rapper, like all those guys was gonna be compared to this one dude.
They lucky ain't come out after Vanilla Ice then.
Yeah, no, I know, they're right. But I'm saying like, but
Marky Mark and a Funky Bunch or something. You know what I mean? Yeah,
but I'm just saying that's a crazy bar to have to reach when, you know, if like everybody after this dude, like, when you come out, they expect you to be somewhere near this dude. Like, no, right. you ain't an Eminem, you know.
Right. And,
you know, so that's just something I'll be thinking about sometime. Like, yeah. But you can go ahead.
Let's call Sway, ask why I can't go up in shape 45 because of you. Let's ask it to scope how you had Paul Rosenberg trying to shelf me. Still can't cover up the fact your last 4 hours is bad as a selfie. Now tell me, what do you stand for? What? I know you can't stand yourself. I'm trying to be the old you so bad you stand yourself. Let's leave all the beef in the 50.
Please.
Damn, can push a 50. Why you claiming I'ma call Puff when you the one that called Diddy?
Facts.
Then you went and called Jimmy.
Facts.
The conference called me in the morning. They told me you mad about a tweet. You wanted me to say sorry. I swear to God, I ain't believe him. Please say it ain't so. The big bad bully of the rap game can't take a fucking joke. Oh, you want some fucking smoke, but not literally, you'll choke. Yeah, I'll acknowledge you're the GOAT, but I'm the gunner, bitch, I got you in the scope. Don't have a heart attack now. Somebody have your hands up. These weak or old age, the real Slim Shady can't.
I was just wondering, like, if that was really the case to where a tweet of some sort was the reason why, you know, this all started up.
Well, I know I heard Eminem talking about, you know, it started over a tweet. He like woke up saying the tweet like, this motherfucker dissing me? Like, how dare he? But I didn't know Eminem called everybody and tried to blackball them and, you know what I'm saying, have his career shelved.
Right.
You know what I mean? And Shade 40, he can't go up to Sway. He can't, you know, he used all of his influence to try to get rid of him. Allegedly, this is what he's saying. So
yeah, no, I hope that's not the case, but yeah, that would be some fuck shit if that was to happen that way. But yeah, to go to that length, whoo, Lord have mercy.
Sure. I'm more on the side of believing that it did happen. You know what I'm saying?
I can see that though. So because you think about it, like think about Eminem and his place in hip hop and how he's revered, and then to have somebody like this dude, as far as how he see it, this dude this peon is like throwing rocks at the throne. You know what I mean? And like how dare this dude?
Hey, man, you know what they say, in order to be the king, you got to kill a king. So man, you got to take the crown.
Hey, I always say, man, reach high. Reach for the stars, dude. Like, if you're going to play the game, play hard, play to win, go all the way out.
For real.
Yes.
I got a similar thing like that. I reach for the planets, and if I fail, at least I'll be among the stars.
Say that shit, brother. Man. Say that shit. You can go on here, though.
Got you.
Hey, the real Slim Shady can't stand up. I'm sick of them sweatsuits and corny hats, let's talk about it. I'm sick of you being rich and you still mad, let's talk about it. All of a single dads from the Midwest, we can talk about it. Or we can get gully, I'll size up your body and put some white chalk around it. Hello, Marshall, my name's Colson. You should go back to recovery. I know your ego is hurting just knowing that all of your fans discovered me. All right, like, damn, you're younger me. Except he dresses better and I'm ugly, always making fun of me. Stop all the thuggery, Marshall, you living in luxury. Hey, look what you've done to me, dropping out just because of me. Damn, you in love with me. You got money, but I'm hungry. I like it this, but you won't say them lyrics out in front of me. Shout out to every rapper that's a fun of me. Know that I'll never do you like this fuckery. Still bitter after everyone loves you. Pull that wedgie out your dungarees. I gotta respect the OGs, and I know most of them personally. Hey, but you just a bully acting like a baby, so I gotta read you a nursery. I'm the ghost of the future, and you just Ebenezer Scrooge. I said I'm flex, anyone can get it. I ain't know it will be you. I'm sick of them sweatsuits and them corny hats, let's talk about it. I'm sick of you being rich and you still mad, let's talk about it. All of a single dads from the Midwest, we can talk about it. Or we can get gully, I'll size up your body and put some white chalk around it. Hey, ride a shoddy, cause I got a road, it's dope. It's a fast road when your idols become your rivals. Yeah. Never hesitate to say it to your face, I'm an asshole.
Oh my God, fuck hell.
We know you get nervous, rabbit. I see mama's spaghetti all over your sweater. I wish you would discover the record that you made a decade ago. They were
fabric. Did he call the nigga rabbit?
He said, rabbit, I see mom's spaghetti all over you. I know you're nervous. I see mom's spaghetti all over you. I'm kind of liking this cat, yo. I'm liking his cadence. I'm liking this. Because I never really sat down to listen to him, really. You know what I'm saying? By fault of mine, I guess, but he wasn't on my algorithm.
Yeah.
He on that motherfucker now.
Yeah,
I like it. Mm-hmm. Like, yeah.
To me, you're soft as a feather. The type to be scared to ask Rihanna for a number. Just hold her umbrella, Ella, Ella.
I'm not afraid.
Okay, Oscar the Grouch, still on the couch. You got an Oscar, damn. Can anyone else get some food in
the- He wilded out, scared to ask Rihanna for the number. The umbrella, la 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 la.
He was like, "We won't say nothing to her, but Bella, Bella, Ella, Ella."
It's too wild, man.
All right, sit out on the couch. Oh wow, hey, funny one-liners, good puns, and he's still on the attack though. Like,
yeah, no, he ain't finished yet.
He's still on the attack.
We ain't finished yet.
That's it.
Mouth for real. They made a movie about you. You and everybody's top 10. You're not getting better with time. It's fine. Eminem, put down a pen. Or write an apology. Or with a simple fact, you wear the disc to acknowledge me. I am the prodigy. How could I even look up to you? You ain't as tall as me. 5'8", man. I'm 6'4". 7 punches, hold your head still. Last time you saw 8 Mile was at home on a treadmill. You were named after a candy. I was named after a gangster. And don't be a sucker and take my verse off of Yellow Wolf's album. Thank you. I just want to feed my daughter. You trying to stop the...
Whoa. I hope he ain't doing some of these things this man accused
him. Ooh, hey, all I'm gonna say is those are not melanated problems.
No, I mean it's all white folks involved in that, you know, move. So it's just crazy, you know, all this.
Yeah, the authorities.
White on white, you know.
White on white violence. White on white violence.
Yeah, it's crazy.
When you get the authorities and the powers to be involved to move with your power.
Yeah.
That's white on white violence.
Yeah, no, but
he's like, at least you want to suck. It took me off the Yellow Wolf album. I'm like, wow.
Again, man, that's he trying to he moving on some that's like some Sun Tzu type shit. You know what I mean? Like, this motherfucker ain't playing, man. Like, I'm gonna wipe your ass off the map. I'm gonna take you off, niggas out.
He's like, hey, he said, I'm telling everything since you playing with the powers that be, I'm gonna take you to the people. Mm-hmm. Get play. I oh my goodness.
Yeah, man, that's how you do it.
Hey. Is he doing it or is he dry snitching?
No, he could put it out there. You already said it, G. You take your motherfucking plea to the court of public opinion. That's what you do.
Let's
to the court. You the one always talk about the action. Text me the addy, I'm pulling up scrappy. And I'm by my fucking self, what's happening? He has to cap and salute me and shoot me. That's what he's gonna have to do to me when he realizes that it ain't shit he can do to me. Everybody always hated me. This isn't anything new to me. Yeah, there's a difference between us. I got all of my shit without Drake producing me. I know you're not used to me. Usually one of your disses should ruin me. A bitch up, I'm Cleveland. Everybody quiet this evening. I'm reading the eulogy. Dropped an album called Kamikaze. So that means to kill him. Already fucked one rapper's girl this week. Don't make me call Kim. I'm sick of them sweatsuits and corny hats. Let's talk about it. I'm sick of you being rich and you still mad. Let's talk about it. All of us single dads from the Midwest. We can talk about it. Or we can get gully. I'll size up your body and put some white chalk around it.
Okay.
Alrighty then. Alrighty then. That was Machine Gun Kelly with Rap Devil. You know, the Eminem diss, the answer to, you know, Eminem's Rap God, I'm assuming, you know.
Okay, right.
But yeah, that was something else, man. Like, you know, if you had to put that amongst, you know, as far as diss songs go, like, what number, and I ain't saying like you have to number it as far as like from 1 to 10, like it's the 10th best one, but just from 1 to 10 as far as like it's how strong it is, you know what I mean?
As strong as I'm judging the response.
Yeah, just this overall song, how it came off, you know what I mean? The response, of course, but
I said it was about a 5.
About a 5 to you?
I've heard way more wicked, made way more work. Now, as far as him exposing the sneaky behind the curtain shit, it's about a 3. As far as a response to a rap diss, it's about a 5.
Yeah.
Strong overall, about a 6.
I think that's probably where I would have went with it, is about a 6, you know, as far as diss songs go, you know. Right. Because yeah, there have been some ones where, you know,
it wasn't a no Vaseline. It wasn't a bridge is over. It wasn't a hit 'em up. It wasn't an ether.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying? That right there, they almost top 5 right there. So he definitely couldn't be nowhere.
I don't even know if it was second round knockout.
Actually. It wasn't even second round knockout. It gotta be about a 6-7. Maybe. Yeah, and if I think about a couple of other beefs, it might go all the way down to 8-9.
Yeah. Yeah. No, I don't know, man. Shit, you didn't do that. You gotta take it, man.
Oh, what's the Cool Mo D joint?
Oh, you talking about Cool Mo D and LL?
Was it LL?
Yeah.
What's the Cool Mo G joint? I'm mad. I fucking forgot it. It popped in my head, and then I just forgot.
No. Is it How You Like Me Now?
No, I don't think it's the How You Like Me Now. It's the other one.
It was something else. It was something
that's
else.
That's above that.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But it was still a good song, though. We not knocking you, Machine Gun. That was definitely appropriate. It wasn't whack.
Yeah, no, not by no means.
Wasn't whack.
He was snapping. You know, he's a talented dude. He sang, and I think I may have run across a song where he was like rocking out or something like that. It's saying, and not to say that you have to be in a specific lane, but he seemed like a rock star, you know. You know, I don't even know
he a rock rapper. You know, he got the little anarchist on his stomach, so you know, he a rock star.
Do rock even exist? Like, I don't know, shit.
We watching the manifestation of it.
Yeah, but no, but this was a good little song, man. You know, I should say good little song. I hate when people do that. You know, that was a nice little song. You gotta look at your little ass thing. You know what I mean? Like, no, bitch, I got my shit big. You know,
you still got your little bit ass business. You still got your little bit ass job, bitch. Fuck wrong chat.
No, people, they gonna stop doing that shit. But me and Silk, we like this joint. We like this joint. We'll fuck with it. So yeah, with that said, we gonna get up out of here. But before we do, please make sure that you like, comment, subscribe. Hit the notification bell, hit the share button. While you're on the You Made Roscoe homepage, you'll hit the about, it's not really a button, but you'll hit that option, you know, and then you'll go below the descriptions. You'll see all the links to the shows that include Silk Show. Silk is Silk and the Guys podcast and variety show. So make sure you get over there, make sure you subscribe. Make sure you dive in them waters. You know what I mean? Ain't no sharks over there in the waters. You know what I mean?
Ain't nothing but sharks over there.
Yeah. Well, they ain't gonna bite you. They like sharks.
Yeah, well, we over here.
it's very much like a paradise. You just got sharks in the water. Yeah. I won't bite you, this shit.
Yeah, that's it.
You know, but just get over there, subscribe, all that good stuff, and get active. That's pretty much all I got. You want to say something before we get up out of here, bro?
Like I always say, if this your first time here or on my channel, leave a subscribe. If it wasn't good when you got there, you'll leave it better than you found it.
Mm-hmm. Sound good to me. Sound good to me. Look like it's deuces and truces to me. Deuces and truces. Let's get on up out of here, man. You guys, y'all have a great night. Me and Silk, we got to go.